Experiment 20 deals with the reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Let's go to the PreLab review page. Question number one always begins with this question about specific safety alerts. And again, you'll look for the triangle icons in your reading. Question number two, disposal directions. You'll look for the garbage can icons in your reading. And the rest of these questions are pretty straightforward in the PreLab review. Down on number four, it says what results are expected when the DNP test is done on an aldehyde and a ketone. Well, you'll be concerned with color changes and precipitates, but those aren't the answers. You'll find more specific answers. And number six, what results are expected when a positive Tollens test is done on an aldehyde and ketone? You'll want to state what a positive test is, what you would expect. And 7, 8, and 9, pretty straightforward. Let's look at the data and report pages. Data is where you're gathering observations from the photos that are provided. And in Part A, the DNP test, you'll want to look for color and precipitates. Those are the results for adding DNP. In B, the Tollens test, a positive test is when a mirror or a black coating forms. So you'll want to look for those in your photos. In Part C, the chromic acid test for aldehydes. Chromic acid forms an orange-colored solution, and when it reacts with an aldehyde, you get a blue-green color. So again, you'll want to note colors and the formation of colors. Part D, the iodoform test. This is positive if you get a light yellow precipitate. And sometimes, rather than a full-fledged precipitate, you'll only see a pale yellow cloudiness. So note that as well. Then table 20.5 is where you'll summarize this data. For example, under the DNP test, result for an unknown, maybe you would say that it forms a yellow precipitate. And if it did so, then you'd say, well, hey, that means that it's an aldehyde or a ketone, and so on. You'll do that for each of those tests. Here too, in sort of a summary fashion, is question number three. It says, check below if that functional group is present in your unknown and flavoring agent. Well, that's a test for the iodoform test. So if you got a positive iodoform test, you'd say, yes, it's present. And the questions at the end of the experiment, again, they're pretty straightforward. But in each of these, you'll want to focus on the functional groups. On the left-hand side, I see an aldehyde functional group. Over on the right-hand side, that C double bond O is in the middle of the structure, and so it's a ketone. Number two, both of these are aldehydes. The one on the left is an aliphatic aldehyde. The one on the right is an aromatic aldehyde. So the question you have is, which of those tests would differentiate between the two, an aliphatic and an aromatic aldehyde? Question number three, these are a little bit like mystery questions, I guess, but again, being able to identify the functional groups is the first step for you. In A, a carboxylic acid, a B, and B, a ketone, C, an aromatic aldehyde, and D, an aliphatic aldehyde. And that's it. If you have any questions or concerns with any of these, why, give me a call or send me an email, and I'll be happy to help.